Greetings and salutations, I am Keb. Welcome back to this Let's Play of Hearts of Iron 4 as the Soviet Union. Trotsky's triumphs, hey. Yep. And we are probably gonna have to fight the Allies. I think I'm gonna send our mountaineers to have a front line. Not against Switzerland, darn it. Strategically redeploy. Now front line with France, there you go. Go. That's all I care about. You can just go there, redeploy, defend. I have no idea how strong these other forces are. Yeah, as soon as I declare war on Bulgaria, I suspect that France will jump in. And, well, that'll get very messy. Very, very messy, very, very quickly. And we still don't have enough forces really to do much. Or do we? I don't know, because my intel is so bad. I have been neglecting decryption tech, and that's gonna hurt us now. So yeah, I'm kind of uncertain. Do I want to risk this? If I don't attack within 2 months, I assume that we're gonna lose national unity. Well, I don't like that idea either. So we'll see. We'll have some time. We can wait until January 1st, if nothing else. I probably should redeploy more troops, but I don't know. And then there's this mess. I really wonder if they're just gonna be trapped there or not. I mean, if they're gonna be trapped there, that's gonna be kind of funny. So I'm sort of wondering if I should just send my tanks and stuff down here just to play ball. I'm gonna do that just because I'm curious what's gonna happen here. I mean, if they don't get evicted, I'd be really surprised, to be honest, but you never know. I'm not gonna start on top of them, but I'm gonna start... I'll accept that one. Maybe... Actually, no. You two are gonna stay on the exact same square. Not you, but the other one. The blue one. There we go. You, sir. Go there. And then you two are gonna stay on the lone tank. I just wanna see what happens. And you're just driving there manually. That's gonna take you how long? You'll get there. You can get there within 2 months. And of course we are redeploying the Alpine troops. Yeah, that's gonna take a while too. When are you gonna arrive? Can I find out when you're gonna arrive? 16 days. Yeah, that's fine. As long as you get there. Aircraft, we now need to consider. That's fine. I'm gonna concentrate there. This line I'm just gonna hold for now, I think. And we don't have the naval invasion tech, do we? We need that too, then, before we can actually do something offensive in his direction. Okay, we're improving our excavation tech. That won't help since we don't have any rubber reserves whatsoever. And those French divisions. Okay, what are you doing over there, France? I'm not sure. And their moving divisions are clear across here. Speaking of, yeah, I probably want to start queuing up that too. A massive east-west transport corridor. Let's give up to 5 infrastructure at the very least. I just want to see if I can get across here. Oh my. That was bad. Not exactly much infrastructure in this area. 5, yeah, that's fine. You just... Mostly 5 in this area. Probably want to boost some infrastructure in the south here too. If we're gonna make a southern thrust. I'll just get something up and going. Oh my. Yeah, it's gonna take a while, but... The infrastructure here is so terrible that... That's a lot of projects. A lot of projects. How are we doing on factories? We have... How many factories? I'm just curious now. We have... Oh boy, diplomacy. Is that where we see it? No. Maybe if we click our own country, there we go. Or if we can... Where can we see it? I know I can see it somewhere. I just have to recall where the heck to look. I mean, we can't see ourselves, can we? There. Oh, we could. Okay, there we go. Finally. 173 military factories, 191 civilian factories. Compared to, like, say, the United States, what do we know about them? Oh boy. Yeah, they have quite a few factories. So let's see here. If we invade from here, that's gonna be... German territory, I think. Yeah, we'll see. Yeah, it's kind of sucky that they decided to guarantee this. Can we do something funny before we declare? Let's say we wanted to drag him into a war. France isn't exactly powerful. They are powerful, but they aren't. Well, what I was starting to get to, I think. The fascist faction in France isn't exactly powerful. There we go. So I wonder what would happen if we staged a fascist coup. Where could they survive for a few months? I mean, that's all we want. We want them to survive for a little bit. Enough to basically distract the Allies. Maybe we should do so in Africa somewhere. Somewhere I don't think they have troops. Just to watch them go crazy with redeployments. And how long would that take? It wouldn't take long at all, would it? I mean, it would take some infantry equipment, that's it. But I think that's gonna be not much of a problem. Maybe we can have the fascists rise up in Tahiti. Better yet, New Caledonia. Yeah! New Caledonia. Because New Caledonia, which is down here, has chromium and quite a lot of it. So that would cause some issues for France. The alternative would be to do so here, so with the rubber reserves. southern Indochina. Of course, provided they rise up, I don't think they will. Yeah, my thinking here, if I do this, and France is in a separate war, can they still answer the guarantee and be summoned into this war? I don't know. I have a month to think about this. And then we will do funny things. We have to experiment a little bit just to see what we can eke out here. And of course, I'm still hoping to just, stage a small coup in the US. And if they join the Allies, we'll definitely do that at some point. Brazil, we're still influencing them, 46% now. Colombia, not yet there, but they're getting there. Paraguay is very much communist, but they're not so inclined to join us yet. And the rest are pretty much, well, they're fairly democratic. He's very fascist. Very fascist indeed. Oh, right, because the communists are now in charge of Iran. No, it was Iraq, right. I was trying to remember how the Allies get a declaration of war against us. For England to be able to declare war on us. Let's see, where is that? That's over here. In order to do that, Iraq has to get more than 20% in favor of... I believe either fascist or communist, and that's it is at 20%, so they might actually be able to do that. For the United States, they require what? They have to ally Germany in order to attack us, huh? As for Germany. They could actually plow down and attack Germany. Our little puppet. Yeah, I don't know. We'll see. At least we're redeploying troops. The French troops are still parked here. It's gonna be interesting to see what happens here. I mean, they're within our territory. Okay, let's see. I cancel military access for Belgium. One of these units is supposedly Belgian. Yes, they claim to be at full strength, but... Yeah, I don't know. Let's see. I'm gonna cancel the military access for... No, actually not for you. But I am gonna cancel it for Denmark. And I am gonna cancel it for Norway. I don't recall. Who else do we offer military access at this point? Let's see. Military access to France, Luxembourg, and South Africa. I don't think South Africa needs access from us. So, no longer gonna get access from me. Out you go. Luxembourg. Sorry. But you still have access through. Yeah, I don't know. Seems really strange. And the French have tons of troops down here. Don't know how I like this. I'm just really curious. What's gonna happen here? Are they just gonna collapse? As for our aircraft, we are... oh my. Naval bombers, yeah. Sea of Kursk, Sea of Japan. Tactical bombers, Sea of Japan. You're not actually finding anything there. We had some close air support somewhere. Here. Maybe I want you elsewhere. For that matter, do we have enough close air support stored up? We have how many? Well, it doesn't look like the cast here is actually going to sink any ships ever. So, I'm thinking... I'm going to take... Not you, and just you. You are going to be redeployed. Way over here. If there is an airfield, an adequate airfield. No, that's 600. Must be one airfield here. 600 there too. Actually, just remove the air wing. And then we're gonna create two more, I think. Yeah, create an air wing here. I want close air support aircraft. Our supreme Sturmoviks. I don't have that many of them. Okay. Move all those and to. That's 400. Let's see. There you go, 500. And we're also going to redeploy up here. Ah, good. Another excavation. It's more resources. Nothing here until 43. Engineering. Well, we want the next computing tech, but we also desperately need to decrypt tech. We're far behind there. We need the decryption tech, we need the research stuff, and we'll see what we can do. Oh, air experience is maxed. We need to fix that. Not gonna make a new aircraft. No, not new aircraft. I just want to see the ones I have in production. There we go. Fighter 2. Mark 2. Can we create another variant of it? We can, but then they would not be as reliable. Right? No matter what we do, it would drop the reliability. I can get the engine up, but if I do more, that's gonna tank the reliability. So I'm gonna do that for now. Shift the production line into the Mark 3 fighter. And we're gonna adjust the Sturmovik. No, I'm not gonna obsolete you, I just want to... How do I remove these? Oh, they are considered outdated. Well, they are, so... Like so. And why can't I remove the basic one when I have an improved one? I don't know. Yeah, well. The same thing here, really, decommission the Mark 1. And we're gonna improve you even further. At least this much, that should... reliability is still 3. To do more would tank the reliability. So I think that's gonna be okay. Yeah, do that. Sturmovik level 3. Change your production line into this new W version. Decommission Mark 2. Upgrade need a zillion thousand. Yes, I know, that's okay. Naval bombers. Naval bombers. We don't have those upgraded to the last level, I think. No, we don't. So we need that before we start modifying. But that's okay, we've used the bulk of air experience that we've gathered up. Okay, we are preparing for our fancy little war. I don't know. All the French have nothing on this front. So that should be enough. And we lost some tactical bombers. We haven't researched. We haven't researched tactical bombers either, I think. We're far behind on our aircraft. Oh, yeah. No, we're not gonna do anything there. No. Yeah, we can miss their wisdom for all we care. I'm just really curious what's gonna happen here. I mean, look at this. The French have 40 divisions and something like that parked right here. So they can't have that much here. And of course they have a ton of divisions here as well. So I'm really curious, how are you gonna... Yeah. Oh my. 200 divisions now. Did everyone lend you the troops? Or something? I don't like this. Yeah, okay, anyway, if we wait, the French will just get stronger and stronger and stronger. So I don't know if there's a point in waiting for too long. What's going on here? Oh dear, what are you doing, Germany? You actually sent ships by sea into Japan. Ugh. Why did you go and do that, huh? Okay, we have some CAS in... Where? There you are. Yeah, good. You in the support in the Benelux. Did they get just give you the orders? Closer. Yeah, just close air support, that's enough. And the same thing with the other one that deploys. I'm not gonna do any offensive moves there. Actually, you're gonna have close air support over Western Germany. I might have to do the same thing here. Suddenly, yeah. Where are the fighters? There are fighters. Yeah, you also. Go over Western Germany. Keep your orders. Yeah, do that. Just in case the troops here starts. Why are you complaining about something? Division belongs to an army but has no orders assigned. Yeah, of course, because I just told it to park there. That's all you're gonna do. Because I'm really uncertain what's gonna happen when I declare war here. We were gonna steamroll. Oh, now you're guaranteed by the United Kingdom as well. Darn it. So even if I did something fancy... What am I gonna do here, huh? What am I gonna do with you, sir? I need to find somewhere that has a resource. I just want to inconvenience you. That's basically what I'm after right now. I don't think there's anything there. Yeah, I think the best thing we can do for him would be Singapore. State of Singapore, yeah. So let's see, stage a coup in Singapore. Of course, there's no real organization here. There we go. I want a fascist coup in Singapore. That's going to require 20,000 guns. be interesting to see what they do. Yeah, let's do this. They're not going to succeed, but they shouldn't get immediately crushed either. Going by our little experiment over with Turkey. So sure. Start a fascist coup down there. And we're going to do the same thing with France. Hello, France. We're going to stage a little coup in New Caledonia for the fascists. Doesn't cost us any political power. It will cost us infantry equipment. But I think that's a price worth paying. Even though we need a ton of infantry equipment. We should have stockpiles of the old infantry equipment. Right? Surplus in storage. So yeah. We should have plenty to actually stage the stuff. Let's see. My basic goal now is to distract them. There we go. The fire revolution. Vichy France declares war on France. Yeah, the fire revolution now burns. The British Empire declares war on the United Kingdom. So yeah, they're fighting defensive wars against both of them. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, so... there we go. Little fascist. Fighting an offensive war, you have one division. You actually got some of the aircraft. Five aircraft. No, actually, that's not... five ships. Five ships and a few planes. And one division. Woohoo! I don't think you're gonna live very long for this, but nah. Do they get the British tree? No, they get the generic one. Okay, there's them, and of course, down here you have the French fascists on the Pétain. They also have one unit. They actually got 30 ships! Wow! So yeah, we weakened them somewhat. And the fun thing is, we can keep doing this. As long as there is some support left. Well, of course, doing this kind of reduced the fascist... oh, excuse me. Oh boy. Yeah, doing this reduced the fascist popularity. But yeah. All we have to do is pay them with obsolete military equipment, and they will revolt en masse. Which is really, really amusing to me. And United States, we're still boosting popularity, it's gonna take a while. Yeah, so now that they are in a war, and I have no idea if they're gonna join the fascists up here, I don't think they can. They wouldn't join us, I suppose. No. Strategic reason to be hostile. Yeah. About that, my friend. Our troops here are digging in. That's okay. Our troops here are digging in. I don't know if they've begun to move. I wish I could tell my puppet to just focus on defense. Would have been nice. And of course, Germany. They still have a ton of troops here. This could get ugly if they suddenly were able to fight. I don't know how many troops they have here. Well, this certainly should trigger some kind of movement. As we can see down here. Army is defending territory, yeah. Okay, why can I see this in... This army is defending territory. No, the French troops here are moving around. So yeah, that definitely sparked some movement. Interesting. Not that I think they'll... Well, it'll take quite a while to them to redeploy. And I mean, Singapore now... They can't reach that overland, they have to go by sea. Naval invade, and I doubt they have troops there. And the same thing is true down here. And of course, the really good thing is that they have resources, which... the Allies no longer have access to. That is basically what I wanted to do, disrupt the trade flow. Because rubber, we're not going to be able to trade with the United Kingdom. And they shouldn't have access to rubber anymore. But now, instead of trading with the United Kingdom, or the Netherlands, whom we are probably going to be at war with very soon, we can trade with the British Empire. I believe. And hopefully that will pass through a more safe area. I don't know. Maybe it won't. I mean, the rubber shortage is going to be significant. We still need another 4 rubber. Let's get that from Brazil. If we can. We're not importing... We are importing tungsten. From Portugal. That should be... Actually, we're importing far more than we need. Let's shift that down to 8. Actually, we're not going to import from Portugal. We are going to import that from China. Much better. We could even import it from Sweden if need be. Okay, so the Allies are now at war with the... Yeah. British war on the United Kingdom. Civil war. The nation is split. The faction to battle for control of the state. Yeah. So they're both in a civil war. Yeah, we're gonna see now. We're gonna see if this had any effect whatsoever. We know the French have troops just about everywhere, which is kind of annoying. I have no idea what's going to happen with these forces once we declare war, because they have still have access. They are transporting troops somewhere, I have no idea where. And for whatever reason, nationalist Spain decided Portugal is the greater threat. They're not. So yeah, they could be in a bit of trouble. We'll see if we can help them after all. After a while. We have to focus here first. And of course, there's also Denmark. I kind of forgot about them. Yeah. Oh, we actually have tons of new divisions. Whoops. Okay, I'm gonna do some thinking here. Again. Dangerous, I know. At 120 divisions, we're just gonna make another army up in Europe, I think. An army in Erp. With only those divisions. There we go. Dum-dum-dum-dum. You are gonna be under there. You are gonna have a front line, like here, an offensive line, pretty much. Yeah, just a messy one like that. Go! So he's ready. Let's see. He'll take a few days to redeploy. We have those three, which are very suited for another tank battalion. Tank battalion for you. Another commander. Old guard, not really what I want. You go. There we go. And you strategically redeploy. And park under that little Frenchie. Just to see what happens. I'm going to take a short break. I'm going to wait a few more days. And then we're going to declare war on Bulgaria and see what happens. It's going to be messy. Gloriously messy. Until then, thank you for watching.